Welcome to a new episode in producing a trance track from scratch. And in the last episode, we have started with the mixing of all of the tracks in Neutron, and we didn't finish all of the tracks, so in this episode I want to finish that. And after that we also need to master the track, and for that I'm going to use Isotope Ozone 8. Okay, so we have mastered, of we have mixed the Neutron, or okay, I mean we have mixed the plug bus, and now we are looking at the arpeggio group, and we already have quite some processing on it. We also have a sidechain on it. I don't really want to change that, so I think I leave this in place. The only thing I'm no, I leave this in place. That's I think the best idea. Then we go to the pad group, and on that I only have an equalizer, so I think it's good to have a look into the pad group, because it's playing in the main section together with the lead. I think something is soloed. Yes, that is. So we will have a look, and I think I will just add the Neutron VST plugin to it. And I disable the AQ8. And for this one I'm going to use the track assistant again. Let it auto detect. Style, balance, intensity, medium, and next. Okay, play some audio. So it actually did a lot of, not a lot, but it uses several components. So the equalizer and the compressor uses several bands of compression. Then we have the exciter. So let's have a look into whether this sounds better. So we bypass it and don't play it. We will also look at the levels. So pad group, let's play it. And now with the plugin on. Okay, to really hear the difference, I need to switch it on and off at a faster rate. So that's what I'm going to do now. Without saying anything, I'm going to listen to it and switch the plugin on and off. Oh, we have also an auto filter going on here. It's not really handy to have that. Let's have a look at when that is playing. Okay, right there. So let's hear the plugin at that position. Well, to be honest, I don't hear a big difference, but just leave it right there. It doesn't sound too bad, so I think we can leave it all right there. Okay, then we should have a look at the sub pad. Is there any automation? No, so let's listen to it on this part. We only cut away some highs. So let's put a neutron on this one. And we let it use the track assistant again. Auto detect a balanced style, or maybe a warm style, intensity medium. Next, so let's play something. Again, I only hear a small difference, but it sounds all right to me, so let's keep it like that. Okay, then we switch to the lead part, and for the lead, if I look into it, I see there's already a reverb plugin on, it's already ping pong. I think we should keep the lead the way as it is right now. Then have a look at the fills, there's no processing here on the fills. And I think we should do something on the fills. On the bottom one there is some reverb. But the fills aren't playing that much. But on the bottom one there is some reverb on the fill. The top one there is no reverb. But I... Well, let's solo these ones. Let's solo the first fill. See how that sounds. So we're not hearing anything. What's going on? And if I solo the fills entirely, then I still don't hear anything. This is weird. What is going on here? Some tracks are disabled, it seems. So this seems all in all very weird to me. Let's play a different part. Let's play this. Ah, the fills itself stays at minus infinite. Ah, that's the reason why. Okay, let's put it at zero maybe. Solo this one. I actually like to have reverb on both of them. So So I also want to have reverb on this one. So let's remove this reverb, and the EQ is just cutting off the bottom end. I can remove these plugins. And on the fills itself, what I'm going to put there is, first I'm going to use a Fab Filter reverb plugin. It's a drums fill, so I want to use a small, bright, medium drum room. Let's see what that gives us. I think that sounds great, so I will keep it like that. And I'm not sure if the volume levels are alright, because this one was at minus infinite. Let's hear it into context. Okay, I just tweaked the preset of the bright medium drum room a little bit. What I did was the mix slider. It was at 100%, and of course that's not what I want. And then we have a look at the effects. I have a sidechain compressor on it and an EQ8. I think that's fine. So then we have reached the end of the mixing phase. The only thing I want to do right now is to have a full track playthrough, and I want to see at if the levels are all right. So I should end up in a not too high. The level on the master channel should of course not be clipping, and there should be enough space left for in the mastering phase. Also, it's important to make sure that there is not too much space left in the mastering phase, because if there's too much space, that's not good either. So let's do a full track playthrough and see what the levels are. So let's get started. Okay, I just started, but I thought about it, and of course I should add the tonal balance control plugin, because then I can see maybe that's something for later in the mastering stage. Okay, what I wanted to do is I have this plugin called the tonal balance control, and then I can check for the different frequency areas whether my track is in correspondence with other tracks, but I think it's better to use that in the mastering stage. So let's have a listen to the track. So that was the full track playthrough, and if I look at the master level, it's at minus 3.4, and that's actually a very good spot to start with in the mastering phase, because having too many space, so if the volume level is too low, that's not good for mastering, but too high, too loud volume levels is also not good, and minus 3 is really a good spot to start your mastering phase in. And in this mastering phase, I am going to use the Isotope iZone 8 plugin. Why am I going to use this? Normally, you send your track to a mastering engineer because it has some fresh ears and other perspective on the track, and that's good, but that's very expensive, of course. And a lot of beginners are mastering their tracks themselves, which is also very complicated. And for beginners, I think it's a very good way, of a very good starting point, and a very good learning experience is to use the iZotope Ozone 8 plugin. And the reason why is because it has an analyzer in itself, so you can let it do its work, and you can really analyze and see whether everything is all right. And also, there is the tonal balance control plugin. With this plugin, essentially, what you see here on the bottom, that's the frequency range, and on the you see all these blocks. These blocks define the range in which you should be with respect to that frequency range. And if you are not within that block, it means that you are maybe too high, you have maybe too many much low end, or you have too less low end. And where do you compare it to is probably the next question you will ask. Well, there are some targets. You have bass heavy, that's probably for some EDM tracks or hip hop. And you have modern tracks, for example, for pop music. And you have orchestral. Well, we have some kind of EDM track, trance track, so we should look at the bass heavy. But you can also choose to create a custom target curve from Audiophile, which is not what I'm going to do right now. But if you have a certain artist you like his or her tracks, you can make a folder with some of the tracks in it, maybe 10, 20. Let this plugin analyze it, and then you can see how your track compares with that of the other artist. So let's see how my track at this moment performs in this tonal balance control, and I let it play from the main section. So from this plugin, we can see that we really need to fix some things because we have not enough low mids, and we have, oh, it stops. That's too bad. I wanted to freeze it, but that's possibly not possible. Let's play it again. So what you see here is that we have not enough low mids, and we have too much high end. So if you didn't hear me speaking while playing, we have not enough low mids, and we have too much high end. The high mids and the low end is okay, but we really need to fix some things. We can do that in the mix, but we can also try to do it in the mastering stage. So that's what I want to do right now. I want to do the mastering and see how this looks like after we've done the mastering. So I start the Ozone 8 plugin. The tonal balance should after the. Okay, so this is Ozone 8. It looks a bit like the Neutron 2 plugin, and here you have the Master Assistant. And here you have the targets. So it's important to select the right target. If you select streaming and It says it set a maximizer threshold for target loudness of minus 14 LUFS. And this is if you want to release your track on Spotify, for example, you should choose streaming. You could also, for example, choose CD, but that's not really good for if you want to release it on Spotify, and here's the reason why. If you choose CD, it really is going to maximize for loudness. It's going to maximize the loudness, and that's usually a good thing, but the streaming services like Spotify, they've put a maximum LUFS on their systems. So you can choose to master it at the maximum and at the maximum loudness, but in the end on Spotify you will not hear it because they have their own maximum, and in the end you will have less dynamic range. So if you want the best dynamic range and the maximum loudness when you are going to release on Spotify, then you should set it on streaming. So as I said, CD sets it to the maximized threshold for maximum loudness, and you can also use a reference track. I will use for streaming because I think nowadays most tracks are used for streaming. But what I forgot to say is if you want to play a track in a club or something, then you should also select CD because then you also don't have usually those maximum thresholds, etc. So we select streaming because I think we most of the time use it for streaming. Then we select next. We should play some audio. It's analyzing the dynamic range right now. It bypasses, there is no extreme dynamic range detected. Analyzing dependent gain reductions, maximizing transparency. So I was already reading out loud, but in this screen you can see what it actually did. So it did the equalizer to adjust the spectral balance, it did analyze the dynamic range, and then it did bypass the dynamics because there were no extreme dynamics range detected. Setting the maximizer threshold to hit the target loudness. Then it did analyze the maximizer frequency dependent gain reductions and setting the dynamic EQ to improve maximizer transparency. So let's accept this. And let's have a look. It has added the equalizer. As you can see, it actually added a boost in the area where we did not perform so well in the tonal balance analyzer. And it also added a gain reduction at the high end. This all makes sense if you think about what we just saw in the tonal balance control. We saw that we had too much high end, and okay, this plugin comes up and says we should reduce the high end. That seems a very valid and logical reasoning, and it says we should increase in this area which we had too low. So I think in the end this all seems very this all makes sense. So we also have some dynamic EQs and we have the maximizer. So let's play it with this mastering on and also have a look at the tonal balance. So what we just saw is that after mastering, we really are better with our low mids. We are still at the bottom end, but okay, we are almost in range. And with the high end, we are also almost good. So the mastering really, if you just look at the figures without listening, the mastering really performed well, all automatic on itself. And why I recommend this for beginners is because it's often difficult to mix by ears, for me at least. And here you can really see everything with respect to frequencies, and you can even have a finer look like this. the mastering, you can really learn from this mastering, because it comes up with all these settings, and it also has a lot of presets right here. So you can really learn about what's good mastering, and in the end, when you start tweaking these parameters, you can come up with your own. So that's it for now. This is the final episode, but I'm going to make a new episode at the start of this series, and there I will introduce everything, and I will also add a full track playthrough so that the newcomers to this series can see and listen to this entire track. And also, as you know, I did digress in this series a lot of times and I messed some things up. I want to explain it in the introductory video. So, and what will follow is I want to go to make a new series, and in this new series I really want to start from scratch and not look at some other screen anymore, or not all the time, and really make that you really can follow me point to point. And yeah, and I don't want to digress anymore. What I'm going to do is use some external plugins. Maybe I'm also going to use Serum, the synthesizer, because I really like it and I'm not really used to Wavetable yet. So, well, I hope you all enjoyed this course, even though there are a lot of things that needs to be improved. And thank you all for watching, and see you all in my next series. Bye bye.